to see the collective processing in deliveries. So it normally happens like so when we create the sales order, each sales order is created individually and manually, because that is based on the list of list of PO which we are normally receiving from our customer. But in case of even in a small company, on an average they almost 15 to 20 sales orders, sometimes like depending on hundreds to thousands of sales orders are being created every day. So it's not possible and it's not advisable also to keep creating the deliveries manually for all the sales orders. So today we are going to see something called as collective processing. So let us make a role play. So Preeti is the sales clerk and Abhid is the warehouse clerk. So Preeti's job is to create the sales orders. So she doesn't bother anything about like what is the shipping point or when is the material available. From which time it's being available. So that is not of much of Preeti's concern. Preeti's concern is to create sales orders, and look for the material availability in the schedule lines, and if there is any deviation, inform the customer that the delivery is not possible on so and so day, and inform them the earliest possible delivery. So that is the Preeti's job. So once Preeti creates the sales order, Preeti's job is done with. Now Abhid has to take over the process. So Abhid is in the delivery or warehouse. He is a delivery clerk, and every morning he comes to office. He has to create the work list of his activities every day. His work list is to create the deliveries, carry out the posting goods issue. Abhid is not concerned about how many sales orders are being created. Is there any, when is the delivery confirmed? Is the with the customer or nothing like that? Abhid's activity is only revolving around the delivery. So every day when Abhid comes, he says, let me say there are two shipping points that are under the control of Abhid. So whatever deliveries that are being created in those particular shipping points, Abhid has to take care of that. So every morning he comes to office, he just looks for the he looks for the sales orders that are due for delivery from the particular shipping point. He gives the delivery date and executes it. The system brings the list of sales orders that are due for delivery. He selects everything, delivery created. So we are going to see this scenario in action now. So let me create at least three sales orders. So A01, over. T-81101, 10 pieces. T-82102, 10 pieces. Let me go to the shipping tab because I want to see what is the shipping point determined. The shipping point determined 1200. Similarly, so So shipping point 1200 11840. Okay. So let me create another delivery, another sales order, sorry, T-8802. T-8101, 10 pieces, but this time I want to deliver from plant 1000, not 1200. Material. And we need to make schedule length, it is for 25th as I requested. So no, the thing is like it must be metal must have been extended to that, that is the thing. So let me check AS210 for plant 1000. Find out whether this article must have been extended or not. Okay. Let me just extend an article slash NMM01. I am extending the article from one plant to another plant. Okay. Because it is saying it is not existing in the plant 1000. Okay. So, I am choosing the only the relevant use, that is general plant data, MRP3. General plant data, we give the parameters like loading group, transportation group, those kind of things. Okay. Then we take the general plant storage. Accounting and general plant storage in this thing. I am saying you can take it from validation type is okay. Can copy from 1841142. So as of now, we have created 3 deliveries, and all the 3 deliveries are from shipping point 1200. So let me go to logistics. We are done with the sales and distribution now, so let us go to the logistics execution. Outbound process, goods issued for outbound delivery, create, collective process of documents due for delivery. So here you can create deliveries for all the outbound delivery, I mean sales orders, as well as the inbound deliveries, that is for the purchase orders. But our interest and our activities are basically mostly with the sales orders. So let us choose the sales orders. So my shipping point is 1200, okay. And this delivery date creation is, so when you say delivery, it's not like the delivery is not concerned only with the end date, end delivery date, okay. So there are few activities regarding the delivery. One is you create the orders, then you carry out the picking packing activity, then you do the post goods issue, okay. Then having the transit time, after that the only the goods reach the end customer. So there are few dates. This delivery date is the date of delivery creation. So let me say it as 20. So I can just execute. What all I did was, okay, so what are all the deliveries that are to be created today, or what are all the shipping points that I have to used to create the deliveries for, okay. So 1200, I enter the date, okay. Press execute. So how many here, okay. So what are the sales orders we created now? 840 840 841 and 842. So we have 840, we have 842, and what happened to 841? Okay. Slash for VA02. 1841. Okay, fine. So either you can choose all the sales orders, or you can choose the particular sales orders which you want to execute. So I'll do one thing. So let me take some, okay, these two alone. Then I can go for, there are two options. One is creating in the foreground. Creating in the foreground means it will execute the VL01N screen in foreground. You have to manually confirm each step by using clicking the appropriate buttons. Whether it is enter or you have to click the save button to save the delivery. That is one option. Else you can choose the background option. So no matter how many sales orders are, the system automatically creates the deliveries in the background, and whenever there is an error, the system gives the error in the error log. Okay. So let me choose these two sales orders and go for the background creation of delivery. So negotiations have been planned for 22nd of August, okay. just compiling. Can somebody say like what are the processes after the log for information about creating the delivery? So once we have created, I can click the logs to find out what are the delivery. So I click the log, log display was started. So the system normally groups the delivery which you have created automatically. Okay. So what is the purpose of creating this group, delivery group? So one is creating a picking list. So we have been using the transfer order, that is we have been using the lean warehouse management system. So to remove the material from one stock, I mean one storage destination to another storage destination, we are using the transfer order. Okay. So the material removal is done systematically through the transfer order. But some companies they don't go for the warehouse management, either lean warehouse management or full fledged warehouse management. They don't use any kind of warehouse management at all. But even for them also they will need the picking list. Picking list is something you give a list of materials that has to be removed from a particular storage location. So they will need a pick list. They also will need a pick list. So in such cases, what we do, there is a separate output type called as EK00. Okay. So we group the delivery, then we take a printout as a picking list for the group of delivery. Okay. So the transaction code to create the group is VG01 and the transaction code to edit is VG02. So let me go to 1/NVG02. Okay. I can see the delivery and I can modify or I can add any more deliveries to that particular existing group. Okay. So VG02. You can see the system has created two deliveries. Okay. Either I can see the deliveries this way, that is by changing the group, or I can select that group and click the documents button. So if I click the documents, the system will show what are all the documents that has been created. So right now we chose two sales orders and the system selected, I mean created two deliveries for that. So let me go to the document flow and say that /NVL02N. Okay. This is one delivery. So I am clicking the document flow. So this is created for 11842 and we have 29. Is created for 11840. So only the sales order creation was done manually. The delivery was created automatically. Okay. Now after delivery creation, what we have to do? We have to go for a transfer order creation. Transfer order creation is normally for picking activities. Okay. So now we use something called as outbound delivery monitor. Outbound delivery monitor is a most powerful user interface or user tool to handle the delivery. So delivery monitor is used to handle both the inbound delivery as well as the outbound delivery, and our concern is all about the outbound delivery. So we will choose the outbound delivery. So outbound process, okay, good to choose for outbound delivery. Lists and logs, outbound delivery monitor. Okay. So the transaction code for outbound delivery monitor is VL06O. VL06 is for just delivery monitor. VL06O is for outbound delivery monitor, and VL06I, that is inbound, is for inbound delivery monitor. Okay. So now I have created the deliveries. Now I have to go for processing all the deliveries that has been created. So now in our case, we have created two deliveries. Okay. So now I have to create transfer orders for them, or in simple words, I have to do the picking activity. So I am choosing the picking. So our shipping point for this particular exercise is 1200, okay, and I don't want to, here you can segregate the deliveries, or you can select the deliveries based on certain parameters, like okay, I want to carry out the I want to finish out the deliveries for particular route first, then go for the another one. You can either go this way, or you can just give it by whatever is due for that particular day, you can go for that. Okay, so I'll just press enter. The system will pick the deliveries that are due for picking. So as of now, we had seen that we had created now two deliveries through outbound delivery monitor, that is 28 and 29. So I am selecting those two, okay, and click the TO in background. Okay. So if the system is asking which quantity to pick, okay, either you can tell the system to copy the system delivery quantity and carry out the picking activity, and sometimes you can even say carry out, take out the quantity from the deliveries and automatically do the post goods issue also. So right now I don't want to do the post goods issue because I want to show that in a separate activity. So I choose pick the delivery from, include the picking quantities in delivery. So that is option number one. Then I press enter. The system will automatically create transfer orders for these two deliveries. So what is being seen on screen? Days workload for picking. Okay, this is the picking due list. So whenever we say due list, it is like there are some activities due for the particular thing, which means these are deliveries that are due for picking. Similarly, if you go for delivery due list, you can see the list of sales orders, that is the real 10A visa. Okay, you can see the list of sales orders that are due for delivery, which means we have to create the deliveries for those sales orders. Okay. This is picking due list, okay, which means there are two deliveries which are due for picking. Okay, now we have done and two deliveries are successful, zero with error and zero not relevant. So let me go and say the deliveries first. Okay. Slash NBL02N. Okay. I believe by this time you people must have got familiar with the transaction code. Do you? Kind of, okay. But initially, I would say like when you are doing initially, don't bother too much about memorizing the transaction code. Just go with the flow. But once you start, I mean, feel comfortable, you will automatically. So if you come to the delivery, so we had seen. Yeah, and another thing is like if you go through easy access, you understand okay where the particular transaction lies in and under what basis they are being grouped. So even if somebody asks for something new which you hadn't used till now, based on the logic you can say okay, so this is related to delivery, so this must be somewhere in the particular thing. So you can go and search in that folder. But if it, yeah, but some people they just memorize the transaction code. If you tell them to search in this easy access, they don't. So they always rely on Control F. control F to enter the transaction code search for that. So now in the delivery, we have seen the is fully checked warehouse transfer order is confirmed. Okay, so the system has automatically entered the picked quantity. If you are processing manually, here we can just press the post goods issue and finish this activity. Now we will see that in the collective action. So slash n VL06O, that is my outbound delivery. So now I had done my picking. Okay. Now I am going to do the goods issue activity. So I am collecting goods issue and give the list that are due for post goods issue 1200. Okay, that's it. Our deliveries were 28 and 29. 828 and 829. I can select them and carry out here. Post goods issue. Okay. The system, when you create the delivery, the system automatically, the system has some activities in the behind like picking, loading, transportation planning, carrying out the goods issue activity, okay, and obviously the delivery creation. Okay, there are 5 dates. So as per system, there will be something planned goods issue. So this is what is the planned goods issue? That is 22-8-2011. Okay. But we are doing this goods issue today itself. Okay. So that is why the system is saying what is the planned goods issue date and what is the actual goods issue date. Okay. So I do enter. Program terminated. No cases storage is available at this moment. Dump error. Slash /0002. Yeah. Okay. Goods issue 1200. Selecting the list, I have to select this. Do the post goods issue. Are you clear or are you comfortable with the collective processing till now? What we had seen. What we did, first we created many sales orders, okay. Then we went for collective processing, that is VL10A. VL10A is for sales orders. There we entered what is the shipping point for which the SQL error 3127. So then we saw what is the collective processing, the VL10A. Then we entered the shipping point and the delivery creation date. When we executed, the system automatically listed all the sales orders that are due for delivery between the date ranges we had chosen. Okay. There we are given 2 choices. One is to create the delivery in foreground and another one is background. So we chose to creating background, letting the system to give only the error log. As of now, we didn't get any error log. Then we selected those lines. We created the deliveries in background. The system gave the log by grouping the deliveries. So then we went into the group. We saw what are all the deliveries created. Then we opened that delivery. We saw okay what it has been created. Then okay after delivery creation, our next process is the transfer order creation. For carrying out all the activities related with the outbound delivery, we went to the outbound delivery monitor. Outbound delivery monitor transaction code is EL06O. So we had created the deliveries. Now next activity was picking. So then we chose the picking tab and we entered the shipping point as well as the picking date. Okay. So the system listed the deliveries which we had created. We selected them. We chose to create a transfer order with the picking quantity from the delivery. Okay. That is one. Okay. Execute. Okay. The system automatically created the transfer order. Okay. Then after picking is done, we have to do the goods issue. Okay. So what we did, then we went to VL06G. We gave the shipping point as well as the delivery dates. That's it. Okay. Then, of course, when we are trying to do that, we got the system dump error. So that is why I am processing it manually. There are only two deliveries, so I can just get away by manual. In case of more than like a huge number, then we have to inform the ABAP people saying that whenever we are executing this, we are getting that dump error. Okay, so they will fix it. Okay. So that's it. So this is the collective process. Okay. Of course, you can do the collective process for everything except sales orders, because you cannot create sales orders collectively. Of course, you can facilitate or minimize the data entry processing by means of your product proposal. And item proposal, etc. Whereas the collective processing can be done for all the activities other than the sales orders. Okay. So I will just show you how we create the collective processing for billing. Now we have collectively processed the deliveries. Now I am going to collective processing the billing ES04. Okay. So billing date from So what is today? 16/08/2011-23. I am taking for 1 week. So I am choosing it has to be delivery because I want to bill for my delivery. Sales organization 1000 and 00, shipping fund is 1200. So what is the delivery? No, 8/28/29. So these are all the old ones. Okay, we will see that delivery duly settled later time. Okay, so this is what our collective processing of delivery. Okay. So did we see creating deliveries without using the without using the transfer order function? Abid? No, I'm asking, have you seen delivery creations without transfer order? Which means we create the delivery, we manually enter the picking quantity. We had seen that. Okay. So, why it happened for us? Because there was a problem in the warehouse customizing. Okay. I will show where went wrong and how we fixed that also. It is all in the enterprise structure. Okay. Assignment. And we have seen that a warehouse is a warehouse number is a collection of storage locations which are grouped together on certain characteristics. So within a same plant we can find various warehouse numbers, and we can find the same various warehouse number across many shipping plants or many plants. Okay. So the reason is you assign the warehouse number to the combination of plant and storage location combination. So for 1200 plant number 1200 and storage location is 2001, okay, we had assigned the warehouse number here. Okay. If I delete this, then we won't be getting the transfer orders because we are not assigning any transfer orders for warehouse. When there is no warehouse, there is no need of creation of transfer orders. So have you seen this, the effect of deleting it? Okay, so then after what happened, after that what happened, so when I reassigned it, okay, then even after reassigning a warehouse number to plant and storage location combination, we were not able to process it successfully because that is some other configuration you have to say when you are implementing a lean warehouse management. Okay, what are the activities this lean warehouse management must be activated? For example, for deliveries or for stock transfers, those kind of things. Okay, for that go to logistics execution, shipping, picking, lean warehouse management. Then control plant storage location warehouse assignment. So ours was 1200 and storage location was 001. For that you have to say for which level of activities you have to activate the warehouse management for. Okay. We missed out these two steps, okay. So that is why we were not able to process the transfer orders even after assigning the warehouse numbers, okay. Lean warehouse management in connection with deliveries. Okay. Then we have to say what is the storage type for picking in lean warehouse management. 005 is for fixed bin storage. So Did I tell the differences between a lean warehouse management and a full-fledged warehouse management? No, okay. So, full-fledged warehouse management says can you visualize a warehouse? Warehouse is a huge, massive structure with very much high storage units. Okay. So, you use the ladders to get into level 1, level 2 to pick the materials. Okay. If you go into the level 1 or level 2, that is the high rise. Okay. If you go into the high rise storage, you can find a huge list of shelves. Okay. If you go into one shelf, you can find small bins. Okay. And the articles are found inside the bins. So when you implement a full-fledged warehouse location, a full-fledged warehouse management, you define the material storage in the storage locations. Inside the storage location, you have the storage type. That is the shelf or rack or bins. Okay. Inside the shelf, you see the materials in the bins. So, if somebody is asking, I want a 10-inch anti-clockwise threaded screw and bolt, okay, then the system is possible to say it is lying in the second layer of second floor, shelf number 30. Okay, in the shelf number 30, in the bin number 2, there are 10 pieces. In the shelf number 30, bin number 1, there are 50 pieces. The system is able to tell you at the, it is like narrowing, just like how the Google Earth narrows down. You narrow down to country, then country to city, city to locality, locality to street. So, how you search in Google Earth, it's a very similar way. It will just say, okay, this material is found in this particular storage, this particular shelf, this particular bin, this much of quantity. Okay. But in case of lean warehouse management, you don't use the bin concept. Instead, you use the storage location. If you see our deliveries, you can see only the plant and storage location, not the fixed bin. So that is the first difference. In the lean warehouse management, even though you have the functionality of normal warehouse management operation, you do it on storage location basis, not on bin, storage bin basis. Okay, that is the first difference. And second one, there in full-fledged warehouse management, you can define a strategy. For example, equal removal strategy or first in, first out. So those kind of things. So you, when you enter the material or when you store the material, the system automatically stores the sequence in which the material came in. For example, if you say like, okay, the materials at the bin number 1 came 1 month ago, the materials at bin number 2 came 2 weeks ago, so those kind of things. Okay. So you can define the strategy, first in, first out, or last in, first out. Okay. If in case of first in, first out, the bin number 1 material will be delivered first, then only will be the bin number 2 will be used. Okay. Then there is something called as equal material removal strategy. For example, let me say there are 5, the materials are available in 5 bins, bin 1 to bin 5. Okay. So, and in each bin, there are 50 materials. If tomorrow somebody comes and asks for a material, let me say 50 pieces, the system won't remove the material in a single lot of 50 pieces. Instead, it can remove the material in 10 pieces from bin 1, 10 pieces from bin 2, 10 pieces from bin 3. Okay, those kind of activities are there, and which is not found in the lean warehouse management, because just now we said it is based on the storage location, not on the bins. Okay, then you have what you call as this removal strategies, and are not there. And third one is there is no put away and cross docking kind of activities. Put away means cross docking is it. Hello. So there is no this cross docking or put away kind of activity. Only here is like you remove the materials for based on particular deliveries. Okay, that's it. So these are the differences between the warehouse management, lean warehouse management as well as the full-fledged warehouse management. Okay. So, okay. You can practice the collective processing, create more than one sales order, okay. Preferably 3 or 4 sales orders, okay, then go through the VL10A and then VL06. Okay. So now we will see the while creating the deliveries, you can carry out the delivery on batches as well as assign the serial numbers. Okay. The batch management and serial number management are essentially the materials management concept. But why we see it? Because at the time of creating the deliveries, you can remove the materials from particular batch. And while creating the deliveries, you can assign the sales or serial numbers to the materials. So you can enable the batch management for a particular article in MM01. Okay, while creating the material itself, you have to enable the batch management. While enabling batch management, the most important point to remember is the moment you create the sales, I mean material, you have to enable the batch management. That is, even before you taking the first goods received from your vendor, batch management must be activated. You have created a material which you intended to create, use it in batches, but you forgot to enable the batch management, but you had taken the stock in. After that, you cannot enable the batch management. Even though you have fleshed out or you have zero stock of the particular material, you won't be able to carry out the batch management. So, we are going to create a new material for testing the batch management thing. Okay. So, I'm going to create a material /n/mm01 t-ap901. Since I'm going to create it, I don't want to create everything from scratch. Instead, I can copy it from an existing material and then modify only the values which I need to. Okay, so I'm copying it from t-ap101. Okay. While creating the system, will give you a huge list of views, out of which we have to choose only what is relevant for us. Because we know that material management, material is managed by various departments, not only by sales and distribution, but also by materials management, production planning, warehouse management, everybody. So let me choose only what are the relevant things for us. Basic data 1, basic data 2, sales organization 1, 2, general plant data, okay, sales picks. So whatever comes with sales, we can choose it, okay. And I am choosing accounting because when I want to take the stock inside, I will need the accounting details. So that is the thing. Plant number 1200. Okay, copy from 1200. No problem. Material for batch management. Okay. In the basic data 1 and 2, you won't have any much details. Okay. In the sales, that is general plant data, you have to enable the batch management, and I want to use the serial number profile. So I am assigning the profile 0001, okay. And go to the sales text. Batch manager article T-18001. Then I go to the MRP3. Okay, I want 02. I just wanted to check that. Then go to accounting. Accounting 1 and accounting 2. I save it. Now I have created a material for using the batch management. Because all the existing materials are being used by various students, okay. And now I cannot make it as batch managed. I have to create a new article or fresh article that was not used till now. So I have created the material. Okay. Now to use in my sales orders, I must have stock of that. Okay. So you can just learn this transaction, but if you are not comfortable, leave it. That is /n/mb1c. That is, I am going to take the stock inside the plant without any purchase order. Else what I have to do, just not like how we handle the sales order, you have to create a purchase order, you have to create an inbound delivery based on the purchase order, and then we have to do the goods receipt. Instead, I can do a goods receipt without any goods reference here. The movement type is 501. My plant is 1200. Because for that only I extended. And the storage location in which I have to put the plant is material is 0001. Okay. My material is T-AT901. Let me take 1000 pieces initially. The system says that you have enabled batch management for this material, so it is going to be handled in batches. Internal numbers will be allocated for that. Okay. So yes, let me take it. So the system has created a batch of 358. So let me copy the batch number first. Save it. Yeah, this is this material management one. But certain things we have to learn. No, these are basic things from other modules. Because like if you want to enter any stock, you need to keep clocking the amount pieces though. No? These things we can easily take care of. So I'm now going to create a sales order for this material. So ES01 1010 00. I hope it doesn't get disconnected. It is taking ages to. T-AT901. Okay. So let me take 10 pieces. Maintain the price for that. So that's the thing. So we'll go to pricing. PR00. Let me turn that. 425. Okay. So save it. So what is my delivery date? Schedule 9/15. Okay, 25. I'm pretty sure shipping point is 1200. So let me go to the delivery slash and okay, VA10A. And one thing, so we'll go to 002M. Just VL01M. It's the best meter. Okay. What is now 25 11843. Okay. let me create here. So at this level, till this level, there is no batches. Okay, you can see the batch management with batch number active, but it's not populated. So let me go to the subsequent function, that is create transfer order. Because normally, if you don't have any batches, you can automatically create and confirm. Okay. Since you are using the batch functionality, you have to confirm the transfer order by saying from which batch you picked the material from. So go to transfer order, confirm transfer order. Okay. This is what the system had created just now. Here you have to enter the batch. Of course, when there are more than one batches, you can define how it can be done. Okay, so you will see that tomorrow. So as of now, I have just entered the batch number and saved it. Okay, now I go to the delivery V02N. I could see the batch has been populated and it is not modifiable. Okay, 358. Okay. Now, if I try to, this for this material, I have enabled both the batch management as well as the serial number. Okay. So, if I try to do FPGA, the system will say that you cannot do because you hadn't assigned the serial number still. Item number 10 refers exactly 10 serial numbers for the assets. Okay, let me come back and assign the serial numbers. Go to extras, serial numbers. Okay, here you can generate the serial number automatically, or you can enter them manually, or even the combination of two. So let me say SNO001. So let me choose this naming convention 2, 3, 4, control V5. Okay. For remaining, I'm letting the system to create serial numbers automatically. 5 serial numbers as well as 5 internal assigned numbers. Assigned, then I did the engineering. Okay, our delivery has been changed. If I go, I could see slash new. V02. I go to the document flow. I could see the goods issue is complete for this standard order and delivery. Okay. So what we had seen today, we had seen the collective processing of delivery, then enabling the batch management and enabling the serial numbers, how we assign the serial numbers. And when we have enabled the batch management, what is different? The confirming the transfer order that required and another step or extra step. So after creating the transfer order, we have to confirm them manually by entering the batch number. Okay. So that is what we have seen today. So I want you people to create 3 more materials, that is 902, 903 and 904. You had seen how to create the materials also, how we created from a copying from an existing material. So create a new material, enable the batch management, okay. Then take the stock insights by using the transaction code MB13. Okay. Before taking the stock, you make sure that you have enabled the batch management as well as serial number for your newly created article. And that is the purpose of the new creating the article newly, because for existing article you cannot activate the batch management again. Okay. So do that, then you create sales order. Okay, see everything. For material, it is not sales area specific, Priti. It is plant specific. Yeah, correct. Sorry, correct. That is a general sales area data. Okay, obviously. You have to. No, you can copy the material for your information, you can copy the material of another sales area also, but while creating, you have to enter your sales area, that's it. For example, article 102 is for sales area 1200-10-00. Okay. Whereas you want to create a material very similar to that 102 for your sales area 1010-00. You can always copy from that. Before saving, you maintain the sales area data for your sales area, that is 1010-00. You can do that. Yeah, while copying you can do changes. Okay, so that is your people's today's exercise. Tomorrow we will see how the deliveries are being split. For example, we created one sales order, the system created one delivery. Fine, okay. So what happens when there are more than one deliveries created for a same sales order, which means under what scenarios we have the delivery split, okay. Then we will see the basics of packing activity. Okay. Then we will see the basics of shipment. There is a separate module called transportation module. Okay. Shipment will be covered extensively in this transportation module. But you can know how a shipment is being created. That we can see tomorrow. And after a delivery has been created, based on your the vehicle space constraints or some other constraints, you can split a delivery into more than one delivery. Okay, so we can see the delivery split, delivery creation split, and as well as the packing and shipment basics tomorrow in the tomorrow class. Okay, yeah, I'll do that. Thank you. Shirisha, are you there?